And welcome to 3ABN's Praise Him Music Network. This program is You Can Write a Song, and it's featuring Lanny Wolfe. Hey, Lanny!
Yvonne, it's so good to be here, as always.
It's so great to have you, because you have been already teaching us some really important principles. In our last episode, we learned about simplicity, right?
Simplicity and repetition.
And then today, we're going to learn about
The power of repetition. That's what today is about.
And you know what? You know, I think that with you breaking it down like this, it just makes it so much easier to grasp, to hold on to, and to implement. So I know you're going to be breaking it down for us today, and I really need it, and I'm going to be taking notes.
And I'm going to check your notes, and I'm going to give you a test after it's all over.
Oh, my goodness. You know
to see how well you were listening, Yvonne.
Oh, my goodness. This is too much like school. Okay. No, but I love this because I need this, and I think our viewers are going to really appreciate the fact that you are, you know, putting it into bite-sized morsels for us so that we
can apply it.
We need to be able to apply it right away. So, simplicity and repetition. If you missed that episode, check it out. Now stay tuned.
Just so you know, neither 3ABN nor I are either endorsing or necessarily recommending any of the following slogans or references. I'm merely including them to demonstrate the power of repetition. Both politicians as well as companies selling products are keenly aware of the value of coming up with a slogan that will be associated with them or their product that sticks in the minds of the public. For example, Dwight D. Eisenhower, "I like Ike." Ronald Reagan's slogan was, "Let's make America great again." Hope and Change was the slogan for Barack Obama's campaign. And Donald Trump's slogan is, "Make America Great Again." Every successful company that's selling a product wants a slogan that the public associates with their product. Some of these slogans and products that you're probably very familiar with: McDonald's, "I'm loving it." "Have it your way," Burger King, "It's finger licking good," and you know that's Kentucky Fried Chicken. "It melts in your mouth and not your hand," and you know that's M&M's. "When you care enough to send the very best," Hallmark. Nike, "Just do it." Dunkin', "America runs on Dunkin'." And like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. Maxwell House coffee is good to the last drop. And the quicker picker upper, Bounty. Wheaties has long been known for Breakfast of the Champions, and they've always used that as an opportunity to highlight Olympian champions. And last and certainly not least, the few, the proud, the Marines. Now, let's talk about songs. In our popular culture of pop songs, every songwriter would love to have a song that has a line or what radio people call a hook that people remember. I'd like to call your attention to a few of these songs that have had outstanding hooks. The Beatles, "I Want to Hold Your Hand." Michael Jackson, "Beat It." ABC, you know that's the Jackson 5. "Stayin' Alive," the Bee Gees. Aretha Franklin, R-E-S-P-E-C-T. Elvis Presley, "You Ain't Nothing But a Hound Dog." And Y-M-C-A, "Whether You Like It or Hate It." It's been going on so many times that it's in your head, whether you want it there or not. Neil Diamond, "Sweet Caroline." And Pharrell Williams, oh, he wrote this wonderful song originally for a Disney kids movie, but once we heard it, we couldn't get it out of our head. It's the happy song. So why should a songwriter be so concerned about repetition? If you're a poet or a writer and your poem or book gets published, a reader has the luxury to read and reread your poem or your book as many times as he wants or needs to in order to get it. But if you are a songwriter, your song gets 100 words, and if it's played on radio or TV, you get 3 to 4 minutes. You get one time to make an impact on the listener. And so that's why it's so important. The repetition helps you to make that impact. It Is Well, written in 1873 by Horatio Spafford. The chorus focuses on one idea. It is well, and usually repeat, it is well. It is well, repeat, it is well. And it is well with my soul. There's a great story behind that. We'll talk about that later. But that is the power of repetition. Some Lanny Wolfe, Andre Crouch songs that highlight repetition. One of the songs that God has given me simply says, Jesus made me an offer. Jesus made me an offer so good that I just couldn't turn it down. I just couldn't turn it down. I just couldn't turn it down. Jesus made me an offer so good that I just couldn't turn it down. Jesus made me an offer and I just, well, I wonder what this chorus is about. Take a listen.
Jesus made me an offer so good.
Well, I wonder what that's all about. I mean, it's one idea, and I'm just driving that nail deeper and deeper and deeper. I love this little chorus that God gave me. It simply says, more than ever before, Lord, I love you. More than ever before, Lord, I need you. More than ever before, I've got to tell you, I love you now. More than ever before. Shows up 4 times. And this illustrates a technique that songwriters talk about, going in the front door and out the back door. The very first part of the first line is opening the front door, more than ever before. And the last part of the last line, going out the back door, is the same phrase, more than ever before. I know that I could never love him enough, but I'm sure gonna try. I wonder what the second line of this Lanny Wolfe chorus is gonna be. I know that I could never love him enough, but I'm sure gonna try. If I would start right now and do nothing else until the very day that I die, I know that I could never love him enough, but I'm sure gonna try. So I wanna call your attention to the fact that I'm simply illustrating the power of repetition. Not concerned about the music at this point and not really concerned about the form. There's a fresh touch of desire in my soul today. Lanny Wolfe is going to write a second line, and you know how he's going to do it. There's a fresh touch of desire to go all the way, change the last part of the second line. For I've made up in my mind, I'm going to make it come what may. Line 4, there's a fresh touch of desire in my soul today. Andre Crouch, a great songwriter of our generation, he wrote this little chorus, I don't know why Jesus loved me. I don't know why he cared. I don't know why he sacrificed his life. Oh, but I'm glad, so glad he did. I don't know why, I don't know why, I don't know why, and glad, glad. Oh, one of my favorite Andre Crouch songs. Through it all, I've learned to trust in Jesus. I've learned to trust in God. Through it all, I've learned to depend upon his word. So we get through it all, I've learned to, I've learned to, I've learned to. And so he's keenly aware of the value of repetition. Now, I want to share with you one of my favorite techniques for choruses. In the last session, we used A prime. Now, I'm going to talk to you about an extension of that, a variation of that, and it's simply A, and what I call internal rhyme line B, and then A, and I'll illustrate this. So A, A, line four is A, but it's that third line where we divide it up, and the middle of the third line rhymes with the end of the third line. And the song, I Keep Falling in Love with Him, illustrates that. Let's take a listen.
And I just keep falling in love with him over and over and over and over again. I keep falling in love with him over and over and over and over again. He gets sweeter and sweeter as the days go by. Oh, what a love between my Lord and I. Just keep falling in love with him over and over and over and over again.
So the internal rhyme line on the third line, he gets sweeter and sweeter as the days go by. Oh, what a love between my Lord and I. And then I actually use that I to be the last word of line three and the first word of line four. I just. Same technique on, I love the thrill that I feel when I get together with God's wonderful people. Love the thrill that I feel when I get together with God's wonderful people. What a sight just to see all the happy faces. That's the middle of the third line. Praising God in heavenly places. So we have faces and places, internal rhyme, line three, and line four is, love the thrill that I feel when I get together with God's wonderful people. Have a nice day is another one of these choruses that illustrate this. Have a nice day with Jesus. Have a nice day. Have a nice day with Jesus. Have a nice day. Here's line three. You may wish the sun would shine a little bit brighter, but when you've got the Lord, he'll make your load a lot lighter. Line four. So have a nice day with Jesus. Have a nice day. One, two, and four are all ending with day, and they're the same line. Here we are together again, just praising the Lord. I wonder what line two is going to be. Here we are together again, just praising the Lord. Internal rhyme, line three. It's been a while since we've seen each other. I'm glad to be with my sisters and brothers. So we have other brothers. And now line four. Here we are together again, just praising the name of the Lord. You got the idea what's happening here. A song that you're probably familiar with, Brooklyn Tabernacle Choir recorded it. Jesus, we crown you with praise. Jesus, we crown you with praise. We love and adore you, bow down before you. Now, you and you is officially not a rhyme, but it's working as a rhyme on that internal line three. And then last line, Jesus, we crown you with praise. Let's take a listen to this. I love that chorus. I love the way they did it. The Lanny Wolfe Trio was in a concert in Kingsport, Tennessee. We were singing an upbeat song, and most of the audience was just clapping along with us. I noticed about five rows back a little lady that was clapping, and there was something a little awkward about the way she was clapping. I also noticed that folks to her left and her right were just sitting there with their arms folded. So as I looked more closely at this little lady, she had this great smile on her face. I noticed that her right hand was clapping against her left elbow. Her left arm had been amputated at the elbow. And so she was clapping as best she could with what she had to work with. And I was so impressed. I mean, it just impacted me. I don't know the lady's name. I never found out her name. But leaving that concert that night in the Silver Eagle bus, I took out my pen and I wrote, I'm going to praise the Lord any way that I can. I want you to take a listen to this and see if you can figure out how line three is doing internal rhyme. Let's take a listen. I'm going to pat my feet, lift my voice. I'm going to clap my hands in honor of that dear sister. I'm going to sing and rejoice, voice and rejoice. A chorus that I wrote, it feels so good just being here again. It feels so good feeling what I feel within. There's just nothing I like better than God's children getting together. It feels so good just being here again. A internal rhyme B, and those words that are rhyming on that third line are better and together. Peace and Jesus in a troubled world. The Lord gave me this song 30 some years ago, and wow, it's more important and impactive today. There is peace in Jesus in a troubled world today. There is peace in Jesus, and the world can't take it away. Line three. And though there's turmoil all around, I'm so glad I have found there is peace in Jesus in a troubled world today. And of course, internal rhyme line three was around and found. A new course that God has given me, it's called You're in Our Prayers. You're in Our Prayers. We've touched the throne of grace for you. Your Father cares. You notice how I've paralleled the first line and the second line. You're in our prayers. Your Father cares. He's promised He would see you through. You can be sure the great I am will make a way. Just trust His plan. You're in our prayers, but best of all, you're in God's hand. This was a very difficult chorus to write. I knew that it had to end in what songwriters call the payoff line. Or some songwriters in the secular arena would say, the money line. And the money line, or the payoff line, would be, you're in our prayers, but best of all, you're in God's hands. That comes out of nowhere, and that's the surprise, and that's the punch of this whole song. So I really wanted line three to end with a word that would rhyme with hands. And I felt I wanted to have internal rhyme on line three, so here I am. I'm needing a word to end line three that rhymes with hands. And so I finally came up with, you can be sure the great I am will make a way, just trust His plan. Now that sounds easy, and it's written and it sounds very easy. But I'm telling you, I would get in my car and for weeks, I would just toss phrases around. This was one of the hardest challenges of songs in recent months that I've written. That I was able to finally, I know when a song is right. I know exactly when it finally deserves to be born. I will not let it be born until it's exactly right. We give you praise. We give you praise. We give you praise. Lord, you're worthy. With hands upraised, we give you praise. We give you glory and praise. Internal rhyme, line three, upraised and praise. The beauty of the name. It's so beautiful. The name of Jesus, it's so beautiful, that precious name. Here's line three. If you'll ask in Jesus' name, anything is yours, just to claim, and I love that precious name. So we have names showing up on the end of line two, line four, and we have line three, name and claim. So claim at the end of line three is working as a rhyme with the end of line four. So sometimes when I'm doing internal rhyme line three, I actually want that to work with the last word of line four. Wow. To me, songwriting, it's like a puzzle. God gives me the inspiration, and at that point, I have to figure out how to put the puzzle together. Andre Crouch, to God be the glory, to God be the glory, to God be the glory. For the things he has done, with his blood he has saved me, with his power he has raised me. Internal rhyme. To God be the glory for the things he has done. If you write that out in 8 short lines, you don't get the impact of the form. But if you spread it out into 4 lines, then you understand that we have, to God be the glory, to God be the glory, line 1. To God be the glory for the things he has done, line 2. And here we have line 3. With his blood he has saved me, with his power he has raised me. Internal rhyme, line 3. And last line, to God be the glory for the great things he has done. Wow. Her name was Loretta Bernard. She was a missionary to South Korea. She relays the story that one day she was so sick she couldn't even pray for herself. So finally, after that, a year later, she comes back home and is on furlough. She's in a service in Michigan and mentioning about this time when she was so sick she couldn't pray for herself. After the service, a dear sister came up to Loretta and said, "When was that? What was the date?" And so Loretta told her the date, and she said, "That was the very day that God woke me up in the middle of the night and said, 'Get out of bed and pray for Loretta Bernard.'" She said, "And I did." So I heard about this story. And when I heard about this story, God prompted me to write this chorus. Let's take a listen. That song has ministered all over the world. It originally showed up in a musical that Don Marsh orchestrated for the Benson Company, Greater's He. And so somehow it found its way to the Asian communities. And it's unbelievable the impact that this song has had in the Asian community. Let me just call your attention to the fact that what? Someone is praying for you. Someone is praying for you. So when it seems you're all alone and your heart would break in two, remember someone is praying for you. So internal rhyme, line 3, so when it seems you're all alone and your heart would break in two. That's not internal rhyme. It feels like it should be. Now, I could have written that so that it would have been internal rhyme, line 3. I could have written line 3, so when you're all alone and blue, and your heart would break in two. Remember someone. Now, here's the problem with that. If I would have chosen to have had that as the internal rhyme, line 3, then we would have had you, blue, to you. That's overload. That's kill. So that's too much. So that's why we didn't sense to do an internal line rhyme, internal rhyme, line 3. So this is the principle. When you're using internal rhyme on the third line, basically those words usually are different words than what the ends of 1, 2, and 4 are. So they are different words. I love the thrill that I feel when I get together with God's wonderful people. Love the thrill that I feel when I get together with God's wonderful people. What a sight just to see all the happy faces praising God in heavenly places. So we have faces and places rather than people. Now, there are times when we will have internal rhyme on the third line rhyming with the last word of line 4. So I do incorporate that like I did on You're in God's Hands. I want to call your attention to the fact that the song Someone is Praying for You would never have been written if Sister Bernard had never been sick, or if she had been sick but not so sick that she couldn't have prayed for herself, or if the Sister Michigan would have not been spiritually sensitive and listened to God's voice and said, get out of bed and pray for Loretta Bernard. Or if all of that would have happened and I never heard the story, this song would never have been. Isn't that amazing how God does all that for His honor and for His glory? So, I want to remind you that songwriting is so exciting when God anoints your heart and your mind with some idea. And I just want to keep impressing you that you actually can write a song. In general, the internal line for Rhyme 3 is just this exciting principle that encompasses so many Lanny Wolfe songs. So remember, I want you to keep your ears, your eyes, your heart open. You just never, never know when you might hear or see some moment of inspiration that might be your more than wonderful song that the world is waiting to hear. You might write a song that Lanny Wolfe would never write. You don't say like, well, maybe I couldn't write it as good as him, or maybe I couldn't write it as good as somebody else. No, no, no. If God gives you a song, you write it. Write, edit it, throw away, rewrite, write, and then protect the child that God has given you. And just be reminded that this is something that you can do. You can write a song.
Lanny, that was so full of, it was chock full of information. Thank you so much for that. One of the things that I loved about that is the formula. The formula, the AAB, which is the internal
rhyme.
B, which is, and then A.
Yes.
And don't be surprised if you hear that in one of my songs that work on.
No, I'm doing this so you can learn to write a song.
This is great. And I really do want to implement this in my next assignment,
yes.
Which is?
Next assignment is using repetition. I want you to write 3 or 4 choruses that use this new format that is a favorite of mine. A, internal rhyme, line B. A. I need 3 or 4 of those choruses.
Well, thank you so much. I'm going to work on this, and you have something to work on too. Make sure that you tune in. If you missed the first episode, which dealt with simplicity and repetition, make sure you check that out as well. You know why? Because you can write a song.